our band can be reliable. Real names be the truth. Me and Mike Watt, we played for years. And punk rock changed our lives. Could be his songs. Me as a soldier child.
I say what needs to be said, you know, with what I put out there.
Yeah.
People are going to interpret it in a thousand different ways, and that's what's great about it. Everybody's going to pull something different. Somebody will love it, somebody will hate it, somebody will feel indifferent about it. All of those are totally valid and justifiable reasons to put it out in the world. I make a lot of different kinds of things, and it's funny to see what people like and what people don't like, and you know, because I have so many different styles of work that people can kind of choose. I like to get up in the mornings and just like ride my motorcycle and go have lunch with my friends and just kind of fuck around and look on the internet for pictures, and then I get over here. You know, after 9 o'clock is when things really start to happen in here. You look over there, there's all those books, and I keep folders of pictures that I print out, and I couldn't begin to list all the sources that I use to get the imagery that I put into the work. I put these folders together for each group of work that I'm making, and it's just page after page after page of imagery that I like, and I go through these files. I work on a lot of pieces at once because I keep all this information around. One image will work on one piece and wouldn't work in something else, so that's why I tend to like to be doing a lot of things at once. This one's pretty awesome. I like that. Bright ideas. Totally sarcastic, though. The flash is definitely a basis for how I compose what I do. It's also based off of how the walls are set up in here, where I have things like stuck in different places and compositions are very weird on the walls. So it's kind of a combination of the two things. Obviously, I'm covered in tattoos and I have a strong affinity.
There is a house down in New Orleans. They call the rising sun. And it's been the ruin of many poor girls. And me, oh God, I'm a one.
That Abe Lincoln bust is a pretty cool piece, too. That's one of my favorite ones I've made. I did a lot of paintings and drawings about Abraham Lincoln, and he's always got this pipe in his mouth, and he's always got a teardrop going down his face. He's like, I use him as like the center figure of the history of the country and the spawning of what I talk about. And he's about as far back as I go, so he kind of oversees everything and looks at it, and he's bummed out about it. But as far as history, American history, what's happening now is not relevant. And I make things look old. If it's something new, I fuck with it enough to make it look like it's been kicking around for a really long time. And some of this paper I draw on is, you know, 150 years old. I don't use the images to teach people about history. I make these things, a lot of my work has a lot of text in it, and if you look at the text and read what I have to say, that's almost more important than the imagery. I use a lot of what would be considered negative imagery. I personally had a really good friend of mine pass away, and that really kind of was part of it as to why I got really into doing all these things with skulls. But even before that, I was into it, but there's a focus on death, definitely a lot of it because of that, because I think about it all the time. You know, a lot of the things that I read about and tell you that that's actually where your life begins, so. You know, I'm not terrified of death by any stretch. And I constantly am doing things that I could kill myself doing, so I'm asking for it half the time. But, yeah, it's coming. I feel it. Definitely feel it. I don't consider myself to be like a fucking genius. I mean, I know I'm good at what I do, but that's just because I work my ass off at it. It's not, I mean, I'm probably, you're born with certain things and you gotta work on other things, but I work. You know, I wouldn't have a place like this filled with as much shit and constantly turning it over, putting it out there in the world if I wasn't working as much, you know? I'm just pretty fucking honest about it, you know? And when people have a problem with what I do, I think mostly it's not because I'm doing it, it's because they're questioning things about themselves, and that's the ultimate goal, you know, is to have people think about themselves when they're looking at this stuff.